Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Solve with Shubham. In today's class, we will go through Ratio, Proportion and Variation Part 5, where we will go through few practice questions based on the said concept. First question goes like, the ratio of present ages of husband and wife is 5:4. Which of the following can't be a possible ratio of their ages 20 years ago? We have been given four options. Now, when you look at the question, you clearly see the question says which of the following. It means we have to look at the options and then determine which is not possible. So, we will try doing this question by two methods. Method 1. So the question clearly says husband and wife ratio is 5:4, which means you can take husband's age as 5x and wife age as 4x, where x would be your constant of proportionality. Now question clearly says their age is 20 years ago. So 20 years ago, the ratio would have been 5x minus 20 by 4x minus 20. Now, you need to look at which of the options cannot take the form of 5x minus 20 by 4x minus 20. So going by the options, your first option is 5x minus 20 by 4x minus 20. Your first option is given as 7:5. So if this is equal, when you solve, you get x as 40:3, which is possible. We will go through the second option. Second option says 5x minus 20 by 4x minus 20 is equal to 6:5. So when you try solving it, you would get x is equal to minus 20. Is it possible? It is not possible, because the moment x takes a negative value, it means the ages of husband and wife will be negative, which is not possible. Therefore, 6:5 is not possible. So we will go with option number B. Let us look at a second method. So basically, 20 years ago, the ratio is 5x minus 20 by 4x minus 20. We would try rearranging your ratio. So this is how it will look. Now, can we try writing your numerator in terms of denominator? So what does it mean? It means to write it like this. This is 5x minus 25, but you want minus 20. So you can add plus 5 to rearrange it in the denominator form. Now, can we rewrite it as 5 into x minus 5 by 4 into x minus 5 plus 5 by 4 x minus 5. This comes as 5:4 plus something positive. What does it mean? It means we have to get a value which is certainly greater than 5:4. Now, we will go through the options and we will see which is lesser than 5:4. That will be your answer. So when you compare 5:4 and 6:5, when you compare, what do you get? We will do cross multiplication. 25, 24. Basically, we want a value which is greater than 5:4. 6:5 is lesser than 5:4. Therefore, this can't be possible. So this method can only occur to you with your consistent practice, The more you practice, more you can see through the numbers and get your answer. Moving ahead, this is your second question and this is based on the concept of time and work. It goes like, A is twice as good as a workman as B and takes 18 days less to do a piece of work than B takes. How long would it take A and B together to finish the work? You have been given four options. Now, we will try doing this concept, doing this question by the concept of ratio. So, basically you have been given, there are two people A and B. We will try finding out their efficiency of doing work, number of days. So, you have person A, you have person B. And then we have the group of A plus B. A is twice as good as a workman as B. It means if B can do 1 unit per day, A is twice as good. So A can do 2 units per day. So as a group, they can do 3 units. Per day. Now, it says A will take 18 days less to do a piece of work than B takes. So, if B would take D days to complete the given work, A would take D minus 18 days. We do not know this because we have to find out how long would it take A and B together to finish the work. Now, we very well know that efficiency is inversely proportional to number of days worked. It means more efficient you are, less number of days you will take to complete the work. So let us go through first and second. So this clearly says E1 by E2 is equal to D2 by D1. So, 2 by 1 is equal to D by D minus 18. When you solve it, you get D is equal to 36. Now, let us take second and third. So, 1 by 3 is equal to X by D. 1 by 3 is equal to x by 36, x would come as 12. So, how long they will take? 12 days to complete the work together. So, this is a question based on time and work and we have done it through the concept of ratio. Next question, this is a variation question. It goes like, the monthly mobile bill has a fixed rate for up to 50 outgoing calls. Outgoing calls in excess of 50 are charged at a certain fixed rate per call. The monthly bills of Honey and Guinea, who made 98 outgoing calls and 218 outgoing calls, were 300 and 450 respectively. Find the monthly bill of a person who has made 150 outgoing calls in rupees. We have been given four options. Now, this is a question based on the concept of variation, what we have seen in the previous class. So, let us assume here fixed charge be rupees F. Let us assume charge per call to be rupees C. Question says, Honey has made 98 outgoing calls and she is charged 300. 50 outgoing calls are free. So basically, she has been charged 300. Before that, the monthly mobile bill your it is fixed plus it has a fixed rate for up to 50 outgoing calls and then it is getting charged. So 300, the fixed component is there. Out of 98 calls, 50 calls would be free, only the remaining would be charged. So they are getting charged at rupees C per call. Similarly, Guinea has been charged 450. Out of that, F is your fixed component. How many calls she has made? 218 calls. Out of 218, 50 calls are free. Remaining would be charged at rupees C per call. So what you see? You see there are two equations and two unknowns. You just have to solve the equation and get the answer. So when you solve, you will get F is equal to 240 and your C would come as 5/4. What is the question? Find the monthly bill of a person who made 150 outgoing calls. So the monthly bill would be F, which is 240. How many outgoing calls? 150. Out of 50 are free, so remaining would be charged at 5/4 per call. This will give you the figure 365. So our answer is option number 1, 365. Moving ahead, this is a CAT 1994 question. It says, if A plus B plus C is 0, where A is not equal to B not equal to C, then A square by 2A square plus BC plus B square by 2B square plus AC plus C square by 2C square plus AB, the value. You have been given 4 options. Now, this question, we can do it in the shortest possible time by assuming some values of A, B and C which satisfies these two given conditions. So, we can just take some random value. Let's say we take A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, C is equal to minus 1. So, all three of them are not equal. And A plus B plus C will be 0. You can take other values also which satisfies the given two criteria. So first term would be 0 because A is 0. Second term would become B square is 1, 2B square. So half plus AC, A is 0. So this would become plus C square would be 1, 2C square. A is 0. So basically you get 0 plus half plus half. You get the answer as 1. So answer is option number B, 1. Next question. This is a CAT 1996, CAT 06-2006 question. It goes like, which among 2 to the power half, 3 to the power 1 by 3, 4 to the power 1 by 4, 6 to the power 1 by 6 and 12 to the power 1 by 12 is the largest. You have been given all the 5 options. Now, how do we solve these kind of questions? So, when you see, basically all your powers are different. So, what we can try? We can try to make all the powers equal. Then, it will be easy for us to find out the answer. So, we will try making powers equal. So, how we will do it? Step 1, we will find out LCM of denominators of powers. What are the denominators? 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. What would be LCM? 12. So, basically, this is your first number. We have to make We will try making the power 1 by 12. So, how can we do it? Easy calculation. You have to make this denominator 12. So, we will have to multiply by 6. So, even top you have to multiply by 6. So, basically we can write it like this, which is nothing but 64 to the power 1 by 12. Similarly, this number. So, 3 into 4, 1 into 4, 3 to the power 4, 1 by 12. This becomes 81 to the power 1 by 12. Similarly, third number, 4 to the power 1 by this. So, this would be 64 to the power this. Then you have 6 to the power 1 by 6. It can be written as 36 to the power 1 by 12. And your fifth number is 12 to the power 1 by 12. So, what are your numbers? The first number, we are writing it as 64 to the power 1 by 12. Second number, 81 to the power 1 by 12. Third number, 64 to the power 1 by 12. Fourth number, 36 to the power 1 by 12. Fifth number remains same. So, which is the largest? This number is the largest. So, our answer would be option number B. Very simple. We are just trying to make powers equal so that we can correlate, we can differentiate between the given numbers. If you like my class, do hit the like button and subscribe. Click the bell icon to always receive the latest class on fingertips. Put your queries and doubts in the comment section. You can reach out to me on my email, on my Facebook page, my Instagram. I am also a blogger. My blog ID is fireinthewings.wordpress.com. I am also an educator on an academy. You can follow me there with the username SolveWithShubham. Stay tuned for further classes. Tomorrow, I am going to start my new course on Numbers Advanced. I have already discussed the Numbers Basic class, where we have gone through and discussed the concepts of classification of numbers, LCM, HCF basics and divisibility rules. And we have also gone through few practice questions as taken out from CAT-XAT papers. In the Numbers Advanced class, we will be discussing about how to find out divisors of the given number, how to find out unit and tens digit of the given number, remainders of the large numbers and so on. Thank you.